Και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνας. Αλληλούια, 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 δόξα σοι ο Θεός. Ο Εξουσίαν ώστε δεδεμένα και εν το ουρανό, όσα δι' αυτόν εν γη δέδενται, και λεγμένα ως αυτός εν το ουρανό, όσα δι' αυτόν εν γη λέγεται, διαδόχους δε ημάς τους ευτελείς και αναξίους δούλους σου, σ' αυτής ταύτης παρασού υπεραγίας δωρεάστε και χάρητος, τι αφάτου σου φιλανθρωπία μεταξύ όσας γενέστε, ώστε και ημάς ούτω δεσμείνται και γίνεται εν το λαό σου συμβαίνοντα. Αυτός πανάγαθε βασιλεύ, διέ μου του ταπεινού και αναξίου δούλου σου, συγχώρησον τον δούλο σου Ανδρέα, είτε εν το παρόν τη βίο ως άνθρωπος επιμέλησεν, άφεσε αυτός εν λόγω ιέργο κατά διάνοια, ήμαρτεν ίσας αφού και τον επικείμενον με οδιονδήποτε τρόπον δεσμών, ον αυτός καθε αυτόν εξ συναρπαγής, ή αριστην ως αιτίας έδισεν, είτε υπό αρχιερέως, είτε παράλληλος, φθόνο και συνεργία του πονηρού, τι ούτων υπέστη ολίσθημα, ευδόκησον ως μόνος αγαθός και πολυέλεος. Την μέν ψυχήν αφού μετά των Αγίων τακθήνε, τον απαιώνος ιεβάρης της άντων, το δε σώμα του παρασού δημιουργηθείς η φύση δοθήνε, ότι ευλογητός και δεδοξασμένος υπάρχει στους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν.
From where pain, sorrow, and sighing have fled. As a good and loving God, forgive every sin committed by him in word, deed, or thought. For there is no one who believes and does not sin. You alone are without sin. Your righteousness endures forever, and your law is true.
Γύρας γαρτίμιον δεν είναι τα πολλά χρόνια, αλλά η σύνεση και ο ακυλίδωτος βίος, η ακυλίδωτη ζωή. Ο αείμνηστος Ανδρέας υπήρξε και στα νιάτα και στα γεροντάματά του, τίμιος, γι' αυτό και τα τέλη του ήταν χριστιανικά και ανεπαίσθητα και ανώδυνα. Πολύτιμος συνεργάτης από την στιγμή της ιδρύσεως της νέας ενορίας κοινότητος του Αγίου Ανδρέου, του Αγίου Γεωργίου, αλλά και μέχρι τα βαθιά του χειράματα ένας τίμιος και καλός χριστιανός. Εκείνο το οποίο είναι αξιοσημείωτο στα μάτια μας, αλλά κυρίως στα μάτια του Θεού, είναι ότι έγινε συνεργός με την αείμνηστη σύζυγό του εις την πολυτεκνία και την καλλιτεκνία, δηλαδή να έχει μία πατριαρχική, θα λέγαμε, οικογένεια με πολλά παιδιά, εγγόνια και δυσέγγωνα. Σε μία εποχή που η απόκτηση παιδιών καθίσταται προβληματική και οι περισσότεροι αποφεύγουν την τεκνογονία, σε δύσκολες στιγμές και σε δύσκολες εποχές, όταν ήρθε από την μαρτυρική Κύπρο και η επιβίωση και η συντήρηση του ιδίου και της συζύγου ή και των παιδιών που είχε αποκτήσει τότε σε ένα ξένο περιβάλλον ήταν δύσκολη, όμως με την πίστη στο Θεό, με την εμπιστοσύνη στο Θεό και στην πρόνοια του Θεού απέκτησε και παιδιά και εγγόνια και δυσέγγωνα. Αυτό είναι μία ηρωική πράξη, είναι μία αυτοθυσία, είναι μία γενναιότητα η οποία αυτή καθίσταται για εμάς παράδειγμα, υπόδειγμα, αλλά και έλεγχος για εκείνους οι οποίοι αποφεύγουν την τεκνογονία. Και βλέπουμε σήμερα γύρω του τα παιδιά του με όλη την οικογένεια και κυρίως τα είχε διαπαιδαγωγήσει και τα είχε διαπαιδαγωγήσει ώστε να αγαπούν το Θεό, να αγαπούν την Εκκλησία. Γι' αυτό και πρέπει σήμερα να εξάρω και την συμβολή του Υιού του, του Χριστού στα έργα της ενορίας εδώ, αλλά και γενικότερα της ευρύτερης κοινωνίας, αλλά και, και στα συμβούλια της Ιεράς Αρχιεπισκοπής μας. Γι' αυτό λοιπόν ο αείμνηστος Ανδρέας ευρίσκεται στα χέρια του Θεού και θα είναι στα δεξιά του Θεού, όπου οι δίκαιοι αναπαύονται κυρίως διότι ήταν υπόδειγμα πατρός και ήταν συνεργός στο Θεό δια την ανατροφή πολλών και καλών παιδιών. Στα παιδιά του και στα εγγόνια του και στα δυσέγγωνα αφήνει βαριά κληρονομιά. Αφήνει την ευχή του αλλά και την προσδοκία του να τον μιμηθούν, να αγαπούν την Εκκλησία, να αγαπούν τα καλά έργα, να είναι τίμιοι και ευσυνείδητοι, ώστε και αυτοί να αποκτήσουν αυτά που απέκτησε και ο αείμνηστος Ανδρέας. Ο πατήρ Διογέννης, ο οποίος ως γνωστόν απουσιάζει, μεταφέρει και αυτός μαζί με όλους τους ιερείς την ευχή και τα συγχαρητήρια, διότι και γι' αυτόν ήταν πολύτιμος συνεργάτης. αιωνία σου μνήμη αξιωματάριστε και αείμιστε αδελφέ ημών Ανδρέα. Διευκόν των Αγίων Πατέρων ημών, Κύριε Ιησού Χριστέ ο Θεός, ελέησον και σώσον
εκ μέρους του Πατρός Διογένους, του Διοικητικού Συμβουλίου της Κοινότητας και της Φιλοτρόφου, της Ενωμένης Κοινότητας Κοινωνίας του Αγίου Γεωργίου Θεόφιλου, καταθέτω το στεφάνι αυτό στον αείμνηστον Ανδρέα Κυριάκου ως ένδειξη αγάπης, εκτίμησης και ευγνωμοσύνης για το ότι αυτός και όλη η οικογένεια του προσέφεραν και προσφέρουν στην κοινότητα αυτήν του Αγίου Γεωργίου. Η κοινότητα μας χάνει ένα ενεργό και πολύτιμο ακούραστο μέλος της αιωνίας του μνήμη.
Μέρος της Κυπριακής Κοινότητας και από όλες τις υποεπιτροπές της, προσφέρουμε με αυτά τα δύο λουλούδια στον αείμνηστον Ανδρέα εισφόρον τιμή για όσα προσέφερε και στην Εκκλησία και στην Παρικία και στην Κυπριακή Κοινότητα. Αδέρφα παιδιά, τα εγγόνια και τα δυσέγγωνα, τους ευχόμαστε ο Θεός να τους δίνει δύναμη για το βαρύ τους πλέθος και υγεία να θυμούνται τον Ανδρέα. Αιωνία σου η μνήμη, Ανδρέα.
Oh, heaven, most of mercy on us. Glory to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, that now and ever to the age of ages. Amen. O Holy Spirit, have mercy on us. Lord, most to our sins, master of the transgressions, pay one visit and your infirmaries for your namesake. Kyrieleison, Kyrieleison, Kyrieleison. Potsa Patrikei, Okei, Okei,
and for the forgiveness of his every transgression, both voluntary and involuntary.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord
have mercy. Let the Lord our God establish his soul where the just repose. The mercies of God, the kingdom of the heavens, and the remission of his sins, let us ask of Christ, the immortal King and our God. O God of all spirits and every flesh, who did trod down death and overcome the devil, bestowing life on this your world, to the soul of this your servant Andrea departed this life. Do you yourself, O Lord, give rest in a place of light, in a place of green pasture, in a place of refreshment from where pain, sorrow, and mourning have fled away. Every sin by him committed, in thought, word, or deed, do you as our good and loving God forgive. Seeing that there is no man who shall live and sin not, for you alone are without sin, your righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and your law is true. You are the resurrection, the life, and the repose of your servant Andrea departed this life, O Christ our God, and you must have glory. With your eternal Father and your holy good life, grant spare both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. You shall wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. His laws and the fullness thereof the will, and all that dwell therein, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. We have horned on a yield, but there only moon, kiddies, you gris, the other's a lay sword, kesos animos. Ο Θεός να τον συγχωρέσει, να πάψει την ψυχούλα του ζωή σε εμάς. Ο καθές παρηγορίας του αείμνους του Ανδρέου Κυριάκου, αγαπητοί μου, θα είναι εις την Κυπριακή αδελφότητα. Ευχαριστώ.
Αιωνία σου, μακάριστε, για ήδη αδελφέ μου. May memory be to him ever tremble, brother. Aeonia sum et macariste, ia ibniste, other three.
Okay, we'll catch up.
Can we go? Hey, can we go?
My dad's life through my eyes, written by George Kiriakou. Dad was born in Leia, Cyprus, 5th of February 1930. Dad grew up without a father. His mother died when he was 7 years old. He was looked after by his grandmother up to the age of 15. Dad did not go to school. He learned to do things by himself or from other people. Dad always carried a pocket knife with him from a child to today. That's why his nickname was Chucky. Dad was a truck driver in Cyprus, delivering various products from village to village. On one of his deliveries to Larnaca, he bought a small icon, Apostolos Andreas, of course. This was the beginning of his faith. He had the icon to the day he passed away and will be handed down to one of his grandchildren, of course, an Andrew, Jack's Andrew. On one special day, I assume on an olive grove, he set eyes on Mum, 8 years older. He fell in love and got married in Leia on the 27th of April 1947 at the age of 17. Soon after, they gave birth to a baby boy but died within a few hours of living. In 1948, Dad left Cyprus to come to Australia for a better life. He did not, however, come by boat as he was frightened by water, so he came with the Royal Air Force. His first job was in Port Augusta. After 1 year, he was able to bring Mum over, and this is where they started their Australian life and the beginning of their friendships with many Greek and Cypriots, which all became close friends and gumbadi. A year or two later, they moved to Adelaide and started their family. In 1950, Harry was born. A year later, Christina was born. 1952, Jack was born. 1954, Nicholas was born. And the twins, George and Christo, in 1956. What a production line. Dad started his relationship with truck driving and started a trucking business with all his children and son-in-law, as they all played some part in it. Dad also got involved with the St. George Church from the beginning as a tin shed to what St. George is now. From 1964, Dad and his family were heavily involved with the church, from being a foundation member, a treasurer, committee member, to a general volunteer right up until his last years. That was over 50 years of service. Dad was the first person to connect globes from a battery to lighten up the epitaphio at Easter time on a Friday night. Dad was very close to Reverend Sklavos, thank you, the parish priest, which organised the building of the new St. George Church as it is today. He also had close relationships with many other parish priests. Mum was also very involved with teaching religious instructions at Feverton Primary School and also with the church Women's Committee. Dad and his family also cleaned the church every week. All my brothers and I were altar boys, and we all made the candles at Tarragon Street with volunteers coming to help. Uncle Efty here and family, including Father Nicholas, always there to help us. As you can see, Dad was very involved with organising and was hands-on with a lot of church matters. Dad was a bit of a show-off, especially with his cars. He had to have the best he could afford, the fastest, and have the best sound system. He was a lad, skinny but tough. Dad was very hands-on with plumbing, electrical, mechanical, anything maintenance-based. Dad did many of these jobs around the home or homes of family or friends or at the church. When Jack and I became tradesmen, we then showed him the proper way. Dad loved Greek music. He even had a portable record player in his 1964 18-foot Ford Galaxy, which he had portable speakers positioned outside when we went to picnics on many occasions with the Pavlos, Nicolaos, Kostis, Gumbadi and other friends. I used to love to watch Dad dance Greek at his children's, nephews and nieces' engagements and weddings, then going back to Tarragon Street to kill the chickens from the backyard to put them on the barbecue, drinking West End long necks with the Pavlos friends and families. Dad loved his sister-in-laws and brother-in-laws, nieces and nephews. Dad was the bridge that helped not only his family, but Mum's family come over to Australia. He then helped financially from the beginning when they came over. They even stayed at his house for over 18 months until they were able to buy their own house. Dad helped them find jobs, teach them to drive, and so on. Dad had a very hot temper. His temper was quick, from throwing the salt shakers across the room if no salt came out, or from when my brother Jack not having his lentil soup for tea. Guess what? Jack wore it. Then we quickly ate all our lentil soup. However, he did not hold a grudge. He used to say, doesn't matter what arguments he had with Mum, when they went to bed, they kissed and made up. Dad retired and bought the farm, his love of olives. Later, Nick Crowdley took over his family, took this over with his family and developed it into more than an olive farm, but a thriving business. Mum and Dad were so proud of the olive farm and were especially proud that Nick and Anna kept it in the family. On Sunday the 23rd of October 2011, Dad's world came crushing down.
Okay, whew. Take a breath. That's okay.
When his beloved Maria passed away. 9 months later, on Saturday, July the 14th, 2012, at 4:25 a.m., in front of his children and grandchildren, he's closed his eyes with the St. George icon and the St. Andrew icon, the one he bought from Cyprus, across his chest, with his hands also folded on his chest. Mum reached out, grabbed Dad's hand, and they walked off hand in hand to under the olive tree. We are so proud of our mum and dad. Dad, I love you. Mum, I love you. Dad, we love you. And Mum, we love you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, everyone can talk now.
Well done.
That was good. Sorry.
Good job, my dear. Good.
Building.